After days of speculation, Carlton is set to part ways with coach Brett Ratten. Reporter Roger Aldridge is at Blues headquarters. Rog, what can you tell us?
Brad, all will be made official at a press conference here at Visy Park at 9:30 tomorrow morning. We understand that Brett Ratten, along with Blues power brokers, will front the media and announce that Rat's time as Carlton coach is over. He spent most of today at the club preparing for St Kilda this weekend, but at some point throughout the day was told that his services were no longer required. As we told you last night, he was due to front a media conference, his weekly one, at 9:30 this morning, but pulled the pin on that late last night, instead leaving it to his assistant, Alan Richardson, who said that, well, Rats was preparing for the Saints.
He's incredibly optimistic, positive about coaching the team to respond to the weekend. So it's in Brett Ratten's mind right now, from what we see as coaches, it's about making up for an incredibly disappointing performance. It's got nothing to do with Brett Ratten in terms of his own future. It's all about making sure that we respond as a footy club and a footy team this week.
Repeating the news, Brett Ratten has been sacked as Carlton coach. It'll all be made official in the morning. Mick Malthouse, an overwhelming favourite to take the reins here at Visy Park. Brad.
Thank you, Roger. Another big day coming up tomorrow. To the NRL, and Brett Stewart has officially signed a new four-year deal with Manly. And sticking with the fullback theme, Greg Inglis has revelled in the number one jersey this year, but Test selector Bob McCarthy claims his future is in the back row.
In the back of my mind, I can see him playing for Australia as a centre for the next, say, 5 or 6 years, and then we'll do a Mel Meninga with him. We'll put him in the second row. I mean, he's going to get bigger as he gets older.
McCarthy today attended the opening of a footy museum at Rugby League Central, and league fans don't go anywhere. The interview with Mark Gasnier coming up in a moment. The recent turmoil within England cricket has continued, with Captain Andrew Strauss tonight retiring from all forms of professional cricket, effective immediately. It's been a disastrous 24 hours for England. A week after losing the number one test ranking, it has now surrendered the top one-day spot also to South Africa. 150 from Hashim Amla, guiding the Proteas to an 80-run win. And in even better news, Australia has secured a 1-0 series lead in its one-day series against Pakistan.
He's hit it hard, straight to cover. Well, he needed that to go over the top.
Mitchell Starc claimed a career best 5 for 42 before Michael Clark and George Bailey hit the Aussies to a full wicket win. Leighton Hewitt begins his US Open campaign tomorrow morning as Sam Stosur, Casey Delacroix and Anastasia Rodionova continued in the second round. Earlier today, Bernard Tomic booked a second round fixture with Andy Roddick after defeating Argentina's Carlos Burlock in 4 sets. The 19-year-old will face the hometown hero on his 30th birthday.
And he's playing well the last, you know, few months. He's won a few titles and I think I can do it if I play the way I'm playing.
Elsewhere, Caroline Wozniacki warmed up with boyfriend Rory McIlroy before making a shock first round exit. She could perhaps learn a thing or two about footwork from this courtside intruder. Maybe, maybe not. Now for the stuff usually reserved for a Hollywood scriptwriter. 21-year-old Eugene Wong needed this on the final hole to win the Canadian Tour Championship by a single stroke. What a way to win with your first pro tournament, and with shots like that, it surely won't be his last. Eugene also wins our Play of the Day.